वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समग्र निर्विघ्न कुरु मे देव सर्वदा सर्व सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारंभं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थावि संपृक्तो वागर्थः प्रतिपत्ते जगतः पितरो वंदे पार्वती परमेश्वर येनाक्षर समाम्नायम अधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृष्णं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतो निमित्रयम् धातुर्ब्रह्मैव संप्रोक्तो जीवाख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिकृत्स्यबन्धादिर्धातुब्रह्मात्मने नमः। शुक्लां ब्रह्मविचारसारपरमामाद्यां जगद्व्यापिनीं वीणापुस्तकधारिणीं वेदाञ्जाड्यान्धकारापहां हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्देतां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं भक्तिप्रदां शारदां नत्वा सरस्वतीं देवीं शुद्धां गुण्यां करुं पाणिनीयप्रवेशाय लघुसिद्धान्तकौमुदी। सो नेक्स्ट सूत्र इज स्वादिश्वसुर नाम स्थाने पदम इट्स अ संज्ञा सूत्र व्हाट इज द संज्ञा गिवन पदम पदम इज द संज्ञा दिस पद संज्ञा इज गिवन टू स्वादिशु असर्वनाम स्थाने सो दी स्वादि सुआदि प्रत्यय सुओजस अमोक्षस दोस प्रत्ययस बिगिनिंग विद देम एंड एंडिंग इन दी तद्धिता सेक्शन दी फिफ्थ चैप्टर एंड ऑल दिस प्रत्ययस सो व्हेन एनी ऑफ दोस प्रत्ययस फॉलो देन व्हाट इज प्रिसीडिंग गेट्स दी पद संज्ञा ओनली व्हेन दैट स्वादि इज in asarvanamasthana it is not sarvanamasthana so here su adi esham te swadayaha teshu parasaptami so when swadi su adi pratyas follow or taddita pratyas follow which are asarvanamasthana meaning not tarma sarvanamasthana it is visheshana to swadi so swadi pratyas which are not sarvanamasthana asarvanamasthana pratyas then the anga which precedes that pratya is called as not anga everything that precedes the pratyaya swadi pratyaya which are asarvanamastha pratyaya they get the sanya pada then what is the bha sanya that is in ek sutra yachi bham so swadishu asarvanamasthane is the anuruchi there so yachi yachi pratyaya pare meaning yakaradi with tadadi vidhi you will get yakaradi नॉट यकारादि यजादि 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 प्रत्यय परे व्हाट इज यजादि देर देर अच एंड यकार यकार एंड अच पुट टुगेदर आर यच सो यकारादि अजादि च प्रत्यय परे मीनिंग यकारादौ अजादौ च प्रत्यय परे विच प्रत्यय सेम स्वादि प्रत्यय बट असर्वनाम स्थान is a visheshana there so asarvanamasthana swadi pratyaya general rule is that whatever precedes gets the pada sanya but if the asarvanamasthana swadi pratyaya is beginning with yakara or it is beginning with a vowel then the sanya given to the preceding part is called as bha so either there will be pada sanya or bha sanya so what is being derived here सुपथिन सो सुपथिन सुपथिन शब्द व्हेन इट इज बीइंग डिराइव्ड सुपथिन प्लस औ जस्ट मी मोमेंट व्हाट वाज द सूत्र बिफोर सुडनपुंसकस्य सो सुट संज्ञा विश्वपा अक्लीवस्य पदसंज्ञा देन कप्रत्यय ओके लेट मी चेक दी लघु इन प्रिंट जस्ट मी मोमेंट आई जस्ट वांट टू सी दी कॉन्टेक्स्ट इन विच दिस हैज कम अप बिकॉज सडनली अ वर्ड हैज पॉप्ड अप देयर ओके सो आफ्टर डिराइविंग विश्वपा स्वादि पंचमे प्रत्यय यचिभम it's a difficult to follow book when you are doing a recap. There's a lot, it is too verbose. So I do not know which part to skip there. See, look at this. This is all, you know, Supatin Shabda is not that all in the context. So it has gone out of context to explain a particular sutra, not needed for us. So Vishopa is the Shabda which is being derived there. Akaranta Pullinga Shabda, not an important one as we have seen earlier. Akaranta is a rare word in Pullinga. So Akadara ad Eka Sanya. Now Pada Sanya and Bha Sanya are given. Pada Sanya is given or Bha Sanya. So when what has already got a Pada Sanya gets Bha Sanya, then will it retain the Pada Sanya? It won't. It will retain only Bha Sanya and it will give the Pada Sanya away. It will not retain the Pada Sanya. Why? Because the next sutra says Akadara ad Eka Sanya. Up till Kadara, Kadaraha Karmadhare Sutra, till 2 to 38 from 141, everything that is there, general rule, Utsarga is that, will get only one Sanya. All of them which are given a Sanya, they'll get only one Sanya. If another Sanya is given, then they'll drop the earlier name. They'll hold on to one name. And if you look at this, the Sutra 1417 gives the Pada Sanya to everything. In the Asarnamasthana, when the Asarnamasthana Pratyaya follows, then everything gets the Pada Sanya. But 1418 is the next sutra that says Bha Sanya for such Asarnamasthana Pratyas following, causing the Anga to get the Bha Sanya, where the Pratyaya begins with a Yakara or a vowel. So thereby Bha Sanya will supersede the Pada Sanya. There will be only one Sanya. Akadara. So that is an apavada to the Utsarga Sutra. Now the next sutra in the derivation itself, the Vishwapa is being derived. So there Ato Dhatoho Bhasya Angasya Lopa says Bha Sanya was needed, therefore all the Pada Sanya, Bha Sanya and Akadarat Eka Sanya Sutra was brought in by Laghukara. Now what Laghukara says, continuing with this Vishwapa, where Vishwam Pati iti Vishwapa. So Vishwapa, where the Upapada Tatpurusha Samasa is made, Vishwam Pati Rakshati. So that Pa Shabda is having Samasa Vishwa and thereby you have got Vishwapa as the Pratipadika. Now this Vishwapa Shabda has a Pa ending, Akara ending Dhatu there. Pa is a Dhatu which is ending with akara, ataha, dhatoho. After a dhatu which is ending with akara, the dhatu should be part of bha anga. It should not be part of pada, but it should be part of bha anga. So bhasya angasya lopa, kasya lopa bhavati anantyasya. Thereby akara will take lopa. This is the sutrartha there, Vishwapa. So what will happen? Akarantaha yaha dhatu tadantasya bhasya angasya lopa alontyasya. With alontyasya, what you will get it at? Vishwap. So Vishwapa will become Vishwap, and in the shasthana, Vishwapa plus shas, you will get Vishwap. In the earlier place also Vishwapaha, because soon will give you Vishwapas, then Rutto Visargul Vishwapaha, thereby Vishwapaha, Vishwapau, then you will get Vishwapaha. Vishwapaha in the Prathama Bhuvachana. Dvitiya will also be a Vishwapam, Vishwapau, Vishwapaha. Then in the third case, Vishwapa, Vishwapabhyam, Ityadi. So you don't need any other sutra to derive the Vishwapa Shabda. So those who are interested can go through the table there. Not an important word as such. Evam shankadma adaya. Similarly, shankam dhamati or shankena va dhamati iti shankadmaha. This is how the shankama shankadma shabda is also derived. Akaranta pullinga haha. Now haha is another word, akaranta. How is that derived? So there dhatoho kim hahan. So here haha is not a shabda which has dhatu, therefore it will not take hraswa. and thereby an exception is given there. Jasi cha hraswasya gunaha angasya. Now here the Hari Shabda is being derived. So while deriving Hari Shabda, what is this Hari Shabda? Hari is a Pratipadika. How do you get this Pratipadika Sanya? So there, either you take as Hari has having a particular meaning, or you take that Hari is derived. So we'll say Hari is a derived word from a dhatu. Harati papani iti Harihi. So Hari is one who takes away your papa. Therefore, he is called as Hari. So Hru Harane plus E, Ikara is basically a Unadi Pratya. And Unadi Pratyas get the Krit Sanya. They are Krit Pratyas. Unadayaha Bahulam. Unadayo Bahulam Sutra will give it a Krit Sanya. And then this Krit Pratya, being Krit Pratya, it is a Kridanta Shabda Hari. Har plus E. Hru will take Guna and then it will become Har. Urandrapara will give Repha as well. Ha plus Repha Har. Then Ikara is a Pratya Hari. So Hari is one who takes away Papa. That's a Pratipadika by which Sutra. Since it is a Kridanta Shabda, it will get the Pratipadika Sanya by Krit Taddita Samasascha. Now it is ready to take Suadi Pratya by Swaujas Ityadi Sutra. Nyap Pratipadika is the Adhikara there. Saso Jisho Ruhu will give you Ruttam for Su Pratya and then you will get Visarga Harihi. Then we have studied this sutra. Prathamayoho Purva Savarna will give you Hari in Dvivachana Dirga. Now the sutra Jasicha. Jasicha kim? Hraswasya gunaha angasya. Hraswasya angasya. Hraswantasya angasya gunaha bhavati. That anga which is ending with a hraswa ach. Achaha achascha hraswa. Which is ending with hraswa vowel, short vowel, that will take guna. So what will happen in the Hari plus Jasthana, which is Suojas Prathama Bhuvachana. Earlier I think I marked it at this Shas. So here's not Prathama Bhuvachana, this is Su Amout Shas. So this is Dvitiya Bhuvachana, sorry. So there Suojas Hari and then Hari will take Guna and you will get Hare. This is after Guna Jasicha. This is our sutra. Jasicha Hraswasya Guna Angasya. So Hare plus Us, what will happen? H-O-A-Y will apply and then you will get Harai plus Us, which is Harayas, and then Rutto Visarga will give you Harayaha. Harihi Hari Harayaha. Next sutra, Vidhi sutra, is Hraswasya Guna. So Hraswantasya Angasya Guna. Sambuddho Angasya in Sambuddhi, meaning Sambodhana Ekvachana. What happens? Hari, Harihi, Hari, Haraya, then He Hare. Hari Shabda will take Guna by Sambuddhau, being in Sambuddhi, Prathama Ekvachana, Sambodhana, Prathama Ekvachana, it will get Harihi plus Su will become Hare plus Su. Prathama Ekvachana, but in Sambodhana, Sambodhana Prathama. Hraswasya Guna, Sambuddhau Angasya. Now then what happens to the Sakara? Eng Hraswat Sambuddhehe Lopaha. So the Sakara, which is after a Hraswa or an Eng, that will take Lopa. So Ekara is Eng, therefore there will be Lopa of Sakara. This Sakara Hraswat Lopaha in Sambuddhi. So thereby you will get He Hare in Sambuddhi or Sambodhana Ekvachana. Then nothing else is needed. Everything else has similar forms till second case plural. Then what happens in the Tasthana? So in Tritiya Ekvachana what happens? Till then Sutrakara writes Harim Hari Harim. So He Hare, then He Hari, He Harayaha. In Dvitiya Vibhakti Ekvachana Harim, then Hari Harim. So no additional sutra is needed. In the Tasthana, this Ghi Sanya is needed here. Shesho Ghyasakihi. So Shesho Ghyasaki. So Sheshaha Ghi Asaki. Saki Shabda Varjita. Saki is an Ikaranta Shabda. Now this Ikaranta Saki Shabda being set aside, every other Ikaranta Shabda will get what? is shesha. Now not only ikaranta, why rasvaha u is mentioned. U is what? E and e plus u will give you u. So in dvivachana, so e and u is u, meaning ikaranta and ukaranta here, hraswa, because it is hraswa. E contains ikara, ikara both, ukara, u also contains ukara and ukara both. So this u can stand for either hraswa e or dirgha e, as well as hraswa u or dirgha u. But hraswa is a qualifier there, therefore ikara ending or ukara ending word which is not sakhi, that will get ghi sanya. Ghi is a sanya given, is a sanya sutra. And shesha is not needed there, but shesha is mentioned there for spashtata. So lagukara there, I think, adds shesha iti spashtartham. Shesha is not really necessary there. Shesha is what remains, but then the other words in the sutra themselves clarify as to what should be. So shesha is not really needed, but shesha is mentioned to further clarify that what has gone by aside from that, and what has gone by there, the yustriyakyo nadi. So that will come up later, we'll see when we reach that sutra. The nadi sanya is given to strilinga, nitya strilinga shabdas which are e ending and u ending, that is the meaning of u. Yustriyakyo nadi, and that u has an anuvritti below where another hraswa sutra is read. So this hraswa u, meaning hraswa e ending and u ending words other than the sakhi shabda get the ghi sanya. They are shesha now. So ango nastriyam ghehe, the next sutra is ango nastriyam. Ang is ta pratyaya, ang. So this ang which is mentioned, ang is an earlier sanya for ta pratyaya. Ta pratyaya is a pratyaya introduced by Panini Maharshi. Before that it was called as ang. So that angha na is the adesha for ang. Angha shashti ekvachana, na is the adesha when in non-stri, and which ang pratyaya, that ang pratyaya which is following this ghi sanya word. So this ghi should be the sanya attained by the shabda. So hraswa ikara or ukara ending word which is not sakhi shabda, so that hari shabda. So here in the context hari shabda is ikaranta, so hari is ghi, and after this ghi shabda the ang or the ta pratyaya is replaced by na, because this hari is not in strilinga, it should not be in strilinga. So these are the condition, therefore this ghi sanyaka hari in ta sthana, what happens, gets the ta pratyaya itself is replaced by na, hari na, then what will happen, natvam. So natvam you will get, and then there will be harina atkupvangnum yavayepi. So there will be natvam, and then you will get the rupa siddhis harina tritiya ekavachana. Haribhyam harivihi, nothing else to do there. The next is the chaturthi nye pratyaya. For chaturthi ekavachana nye pratyaya gher niti gunaha supi. So when the sup pratyaya follows, which is a niti supi, so niti supi means it should be a gnit pratyaya. So this will be what, nit will be what, fourth case singular, fifth case singular, sixth case singular, seventh case singular, all are nit pratyas. So this nit and it all are sup pratyaya. So in that case what will happen, the ghi sanyaka shabda will take guna, so there will be guna, hari will become hare. So now what I said is hari plus ne, chaturthi ekvachana will become hare plus a. Nyakara is an ith letter, nit. So a, you will get hare plus a, then hoayava will give you haraye. So chaturthi ekvachana is hare. Haribhyam haribhya, anyway no other special sutra needed. Then hari plus nyasi, nyasi is panchami ekvachana and nyas is shashti ekvachana. So this nyasi is panchami ekvachana. So here what will happen, this by the earlier sutra anyway you will get, here niti will give you guna. So hare plus us will be, hoayava is prapta now. Now do you expect the hare plus us So if you actually do not get another sutra, what would you derive? You will get hoyava and then harayaha. This will be the form which is in the first case plural. So generally in Marut Shabda also, see, first case plural, second case plural, fifth case singular and sixth case singular, the forms are same, Marutaha. Why? Because nothing special is there, content is us only. In first case plural, second case plural, fifth and sixth case singulars, content of the pratyaya is us. So that is expected here, Hare plus us also would cause this HOAYA to be invoked and Harayaha is Prapta there. However, the next sutra is Apavada to it. So Vidhi Sutra, Lagukara reads as Nyasignyasoscha. Nyasi is Panchami Ekvachana. And Nyasoho, Nyas is what? Shashti Ekvachana. In these two places, what will happen? Engaha Ati Purvaha Ekaha Purva Parayo Samhitayam. When there is a Sandhi there, then single Adesha, which is that Purva. For Purva Para, both there is a single Purva Adesha. When Ati, so Ati Nyasi Gnyaso. So when the Gnyas Pratya or Nyasi Pratya, which has an At Akara, then what will happen? That At Akara of Nyas or Nyasi Pratya, mean Panchami or Shashti Akara, that Akara along with the earlier Eng, both are replaced by Puro Rupa, meaning Ekara is there. Hari has become what? Hari has become Hare by Gunam, there Nithi. And then this Hare Ekara is Eng. So this Eng of the Hare and Akara of Nyasi or Nyas Pratya both together replaced by Puro Rupa Ekara. So therefore what will get? Hare plus Sakara, Hares. Hares will become with Rutva Visarga Harehe. So Panchami and Shashti Ekvachana are Harehe. So this is the Panchami Ekvachana as well as Shashti Ekvachana. Then Hari plus Os, Panchami and Shashti, Shashti Dvivachana and Saptami Dvivachana. What will happen? Hari plus Os. There Eko Yanachi will give you Haryos and then Saso Yushoru will give you Rutto Visarga and Karavasana Visarjan. Rutto Visarga will give you Haryoho. So this is the Shashti and Saptami Dvivachana. Hariyoho. In the Shashti Bahuvachana, what happens? Hari Naam. How? Hari plus Aam, then Harsvanadhyapo Nut, Nudagama comes in, Adyanto Takito will apply to the Pratyas beginning and then Pratya Aam will become Naam, Hari Naam, then Nami Angasya Dirgaha. When Naam is the form of the Shashti Bahuvachana Pratya following, then Anga will take Dirgaha, Ikara will become Ikara, Hari Naam, and then Atkupangnu Vyavayipi, what? Prashabhyam Nodaha Samanapade Hari Naam. You will get Hari Naam. Achaghehe Idudbhyam Aut Nyehe. So this sutra is interesting in the sense Achaghehe. This gives two Adeshas. This Vidhi Sutra gives two Adeshas. One is what? This Ni Pratya, Saptami Ekvachana Pratya, which would otherwise have caused Guna being Niti, Nit Pratya being Nit, it would have caused Niti Supi. What will happen? Gher Niti Gunaha, Angasya Gunaha, would have caused Guna in the beginning. But Ikaranta and Ukaranta, here Ikaranta Hari Shabda and Guru Shabda also, Ukaranta, which are Ghi, Ghi Sanyaka. Both are what? Ghi Sanyaka, sorry, both are Ghi Sanyaka. So what will happen there? These are both Ghi Sanyaka. So Achcha Ghe He, what will happen? At is the Adesha, At. Atcha is there. At is also an Adesha. What other Adesha? Idud Bhyam. So It and Ut, Ikara ending and Ukara ending. Ghi Shabda, after that, after the Ikara ending or Ukara ending, Ghi Shabda, Ghe He, this Ghe He, Nye He, when Saptami Ekvachana Ni Pratya, that Saptami Ekvachana Ni Pratya, when it follows, then Aut is also an Adesha. So Aut is an Adesha. Nye He Aut. Nye is in Shashti Ekvachana. I mentioned Saptami Ekvachana is the Pratya, Ni Pratya. So this is Ni, Nye He. सो ज्ञेहे फॉर दिस सेवेंथ के सिंगुलर सुप्रत्याग्नि ज्ञेहे षष्ठी एक वचन ऑफ दैट इज ज्ञेहे. सो फॉर दिस नी प्रत्यय औत इज द आदेश एंड दी अत आदेश अकार इज द आदेश फॉर दी घी शब्द विच इज एंडिंग विथ इकार एंड उकार. सो दिस इदुद्भ्याम औत इदुद्भ्याम परस्य ज्ञेहे औत ने विल गेट दी औत आदेश एंड अच्च घे हे अच्च घी घी शब्द विल टेक अत आदेश. सो सो वॉट इज मेन्शन इज सो दिस घे हे षष्ठी एक वचन बट दिस षष्ठी एंड दिस षष्ठी आर डिफरेंट. घी एंड नी आर टोटली डिफरेंट. घी इज बिफोर दिस नी प्रत्यय. घी इज एन अंग एंड नी इज अ प्रत्यय. सो these two will go together, there will be ni will be replaced by aut, so aut will replace ni and at will replace this last letter of the ghi sanyaka shabda. Hari ikara or ukara is replaced by akara, so what that means is this ikara ukara will be replaced by akara and ni will be replaced by aukara. Aut is aukara. So there are two adesha, this is first adesha, this is another adesha, so it is shown separately here. Akara adesha for ghi, which ghi? Ikara ending or ukara ending. So ikara or ukara is replaced. Hari will become hara and guru will become gura. Then plus what? Aukara here. Aukara to the pratyaya in the saptami ekvachana. So what happens here? Hari plus ni, this is saptami ekvachana pratyaya. Nye he out, so out is the adesha and then hari ikara will become hara akara. So accha ghe idudbhyam out nye he. Then hara plus au, what level? Vriddhi rechi. सो एची परे एची औ परे औकार परे वृद्धि विल बी दी आदेश एंड देन यू विल गेट दी फॉर्म हरऊ इन सप्तमी एक वचन. इन सप्तमी बहुवचन व्हाट विल हैपन? हरि प्लस सु पकार विल गो अवे हरिसु हरिसु एंड आदेश प्रत्ययो हो इनको हो सकारस्य अपदांतस्य सकारस्य मूर्धन्य. सो दिस अपदांत अपदांतस्य इज एन अनुवृत्ति देयर. अपदांतस्य सकारस्य मूर्धन्यः इनको हो सह मूर्धन्य कस्य अपदांतस्य सकारस्य विच इज एन आदेश सकार और प्रत्यय सकार. हियर इट इज अ प्रत्यय सकार देयर फॉर इट विल टेक मूर्धन्य आदेश एंड बिकम षण्मुख सकार हरिषु एवं कवि आदेय सिमिलरली कवि इत्यादि वर्ड्स. So what happens to Sakhi Shabda? Sakhi Shabda will not get the Ghi Sanya, so it will not decline like Hari. So where is the change? For that the other sutras follow. Vidhi Sutra Anang Sau. Anang Sau. Sakyuhu Angasyas Asambuddhau. So except in Sambuddhi, in non-Sambuddhi, which pratyaya there? Su. So Su pratyaya Sau. Sau pare. Sau is Saptami Ekvachana. Anang is the Adesha. So anang will be the adesha for su when su pratyaya follows for the sakhi shabda. Sakyuhu angasya. Sakyuhu angasya. So the sakyu shabda, which sakhi shabda, which is the anga in non sambuddhi, what will happen? This non sambuddhi su pratyaya when it is following, then the sakhi shabda will get the anang adesha. And this anang nitya. So anang adesha nitya alantasya alantasya nitya. So anang is a nit adesha. The content is ana. So this ana, so just akara is for uccharanartha. So akara after nakara is uccharanartha. So the content is what? An. An is the content here. So an will be the adesha and being nit adesha, multi-letter nit adesha, it will not replace the entire sakhi shabda. It will replace only the last letter alantya seva. Therefore, Sakhi will become what? Ikara will be replaced by An and you will get Sakhan. Sakhan will be the Anga there. Sakhi will become Sakhan. Ikara will be replaced by An. You will get Sakhan. Sakhan plus Sa. Now what happens here? Sakhan plus Sa to be continued. So next sutra is needed here. Alontyat Puro Upadha Asanya Sutra. What is Upadha? Upadha is the penultimate or the second last letter. How do you get that Sanya? पूर्व वॉट इज पूर्व अंत्यात अलह पूर्व पूर्व अलह अंत्यात अलह पूर्व उपधा. सो दिस इज द अंत्य अल अंते भव अंत. सो दिस इज द अंत्य अल antya al last letter before this purva will get the upada sanya. So this is purva, meaning the second last letter or the penultimate letter gets the upada sanya. Sanya sutra, why do you need this? Sarvanamasthane cha sambuddhau naha upadhayah dirgha angasya. So naha dirgha upadanta, this nakara, nakara is at the end. So the upada of this nakara, nakara is the last letter, upada will be the penultimate letter of that shabda ending with this nakara. So this nakara before this nakara is called as upada. We got that from the earlier sanya sutra. Upadayaha dirgha, that upada will take dirgha. Upadayaha shashti ekvachana dirgha kasya, what kind of kasyaha upadayaha. So there upada which is naha, so naha upadayaha meaning the upada of the nakara. They are not in samanadikaranyam because just because they are in shashti ekvachana, the upada of the nakara of what? Of the anga, angasya. So nakara, you can say naha angasya. So nakarantasya angasya upadayaha. So these two are together. So you can say nakarantasya, by tadanta vidhi, you can say nakarantasya angasya upada, ya upada, tasyaha upadayaha, jirgaha adesha bhavati. Thereby what will happen? Now, sakhan, sakhi which has become sakhan, will become sakhan. Akara, which is upada akara, will take dirga. So you will get sakhan. When? Asambuddhu. Only when? In sarvanamasthana, when sarvanamasthana pratyaya follows and it is not sambuddhi, then the upada will take dirga adesha. So here we are deriving prathama ekvachana. Prathama ekvachana is not sambodhana. Therefore, this is not in sambuddhi. Therefore, sakhan will become what? Sakhan. Sakhan plus sakara. What will happen now? Sakhan plus sakara aprukte ekal pratyaha. Another sanya is needed. Sanya sutra. What is the sanya here? Aprukta is a sanya. Who gets this aprukta sanya? Ekal pratyaha. Ekaha al yasmin pratyaye saha pratyaha ekal pratyaha. The ekal is a sanya. Ekal pratyaha is predicated with a sanya as aprukta. It will be called as aprukta. Meaning if a pratyaya has only single letter left, then that pratyaya will be called as aprukta. Is it is made in vera prukta sityadi lopaha. So what will happen now with this sanya? Halnya abhyo dirga sutisya pruktam hal lopaha. Lopa means lupyate. Lopa is the adesha here, meaning lupyate. What will take lopa? Hal, hal lopaha. Hal lopa means hal will take lopa. This hal, actually hal, although it is in prathama, if you take hal and lopaha in prathama, this lopa should be converted into what? Lupyate. Takes lopa. This hal lupyate. Because hal is in prathama. And which hal will go away? That hal which is aprukta hal. Apruktam hal lupyate. Aprukta means what? A single letter which is a consonant. What single letter? The single letter left of a pratyaya. In supratyaya, sakara is left. That sakara which is a hal. And since it is a single letter of a pratyaya, it has got as aprukta sanya. So aprukta hal sakara of su sutisi. Sutisi meaning this aprukta hal pratyaya of su sakara or tip or sip. So tip and sip are not the focus here. Su is the focus. So su, su sakara after sakan, 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 su. That sakan sakara is a su pratyaya, su tisi. So not a tip or a sip aprukta hal, but su aprukta hal here in this case. And what does hal mean really here? Hal nyabhyo, this hal, hal nyabhyo panchami bahuvachana, after a hal niyanta or abanta, which we saw in nyap pratipadika. There we saw ni and ap. So niyanta and abanta are strilinga shabdas. Here also after a niyanta shabda or a avanta shabda, strilinga shabda or a halanta shabda, after halanta shabda. So hal, dirgha, ni or aap, strilinga should be preceding the aprukta hal. Then what will happen? Or what? Dirgha. Here dirgha specifically says dirgha. Dirgha, ni or aap. So here our शब्दा इज वॉट सखी हैज बिकम सखान, इट हैज टेकन द फॉर्म सखान एंड देन यू हैव सू सकारा, सू सकारा. सो नाउ यू हैव हल, हल कंडीशन इज सेटिस्फाइड. दिस सकारा इज प्रत्यय सकारा विच इज अ सिंगल लेटर, देयरफॉर इट इज अप्रुक्ता. सो अप्रुक्ता इज मेट, इट इज सू प्रत्यय अप्रुक्ता एंड इट इज हल सकारा एंड इट इज आफ्टर अ आफ्टर दिस हल, हल अंत शब्द. देयरफॉर दीज कंडीशंस आर मेट एंड देयर बाय हल अप्रुक्त हल लुप्यते, सकारा लुप्यते. सो यू विल गेट सकान, सकान विल बी द फॉर्म हियर. सो यू यू विल हैव डिराइव टिल सखान, सकारा लोप विल टेक प्लेस. नाउ वॉट हैपन्स, टू बी कंटिन्यूड, यू आर स्टिल नॉट डिराइव, देन वॉट हैपन्स, न लोप प्रातिपदिकांतस्य अंग पदस्य. सो पदस्य प्रातिपदिकांतस्य नकारस्य लोपः. सो न लोप, आई थिंक दिस इज नह लोप, न लोप, न इज टेकन एज षष्ठी एंड लोप इज प्रथमा एकवचन. सो हियर न इज एंड लोप इज स्प्लिट बाय लघुकार. इन कौमुदी ग्रंथ दिस न इज सेट टू बी वॉट लुप्त षष्ठी निर्देश, हैविंग लुप्त षष्ठी. सो दे रीड इट एज नह और नकारस्य. In the in Kashika, I think it is nalopa is taken as a samasa and then naha lopaha nalopaha or nakarasya lopaha nalopaha, that kind of samasa is seen. It is seen as a single word. So nakarasya lopaha kada bhavati, when it is at the end of a pada and also at the end of the pratipadika. So nakara, which is at the end of the pratipadika and continues to be at the end of the pada, that nakara will undergo lopa, it will be taken away. So sakhan nakara is a pratipadika ending nakara and it is also the pada's ending nakara, sakhan. Therefore what will happen, see, sakhi ikara was already replaced by an. So sakhi shabda is sakhin shabda now, sakhan shabda now. So sakhi, which has become sakhan, nakara is at the end of the pratipadika and now this sakhan nakara is also at the end of the pada because this entire thing is a pada, supting antam padam, and sakara aprukta hal has been taken away. So sakhan is a pada. Now this sakhan, which is having nakara at the end of the pada, and sakhan shabda, which had nakara at the end of the pratipadika, they are the same. So these two being same, what will happen, nalopa pratipadika antasya na will go away and you will get sakha, which is the Rupa Siddhi Prathama Ekvachana. So, so much for the Sakhi Shabda in comparison to the Hari Shabda, which is getting the Ghi Sanya. So, this is Prathama Ekvachana. Now, what happens in Au? Su Au Jasso Au De Sakyura Sambuddhau Angat Sarvanamasthanam Nit. So, Sakyura Asambuddhau is the Sutra. Sakyuhu, after the Sakhi Shabda, Panchami Ekvachana, after the Sakhi Shabda, Asambuddhi, Asambuddhau, when the Sarvanamasthanam, Sarvanamasthanam, which is other than Sambuddhi, following, then what will happen? Angat, after that Anga, Nit. Nit meaning what? The Sakhi Shabda, Sarvanamasthana, which is not Sambuddhi, is treated like Nit. Nit meaning Nitvat. So, Lagukara says, Sakyu Angat Param, Sambuddhi Varjam Sarvanamasthanam, that Sarvanamasthana which is other than Sambuddhi will be treated as what? Like Nit, Nidvat Syat. So it should be treated like Nit, meaning the Pratyaya will be treated like Nit. This Pratyaya, which is in a non-Sambuddhi Sarvanamasthana following the Sakhi Shabda alone, only Sakhi Shabda will be treated like Nit. So as though there is a Nakara which has gone away, so what will that give you? It will help you cause vriddhi, because achonyiti ityadi, achonyiti tells you that anga can take vriddhi due to the pratyaya being nit. Here it is not really nit, it is deemed to be nit. So nidvat syat means deemed to be nit. Just like in tinganta you see the pratyaya which is getting the tingshit sarvadhatukam, sarvadhatuka sanya is there, then tingshit sarvadhatukam, but sarvadhatukam apit, that is not having pakara as a nit, is deemed to be nit. Sarvadhatukam apit nit. So nidvat, although the sarvadhatuka non pit pratyaya pakara is not a nit, such kind of a thing or a shit pratyaya will be deemed to be a nit pratyaya, meaning as though it has a nyakara, it will behave as though it has a nyakara as a nit letter. Similarly here, sarvanama sthana other than sambuddhi, which follows the sakhi shabda, will be treated as nit. Then what happens? Achunniti. Achunniti sutra gives you angasya vriddhi. Then anga can take vriddhi. Now what is the anga here? Sakhi is the anga. So sakhi is the anga. Au pratyaya is prathama dvivachana, and out will also give you dvitiya dvivachana. Out. So au will be the content there. Bracketed out also. So what will happen? Ikara. This au is not a sambuddhi pratyaya. And it is sarvanama sthana. How? Sudanapunsakasya. The first five are in sut, not are in sut. First five are sut pratyas. And it is in non anapunsaka. So non napunsaka, it is a pullinga shabda, sakhi. Thereby, sarvanama sthana is there for this pratyaya. Sarvanama sthana is a sanya. Plus, it is non sambuddhi pratyaya. Therefore, it will be treated as nit. Following this sakhi shabda, thereby nitvat achunniti. So this will become nitvat. Nitvat, and then nitvat syat. Au is like nit, and therefore achunniti. When a nit pratyaya follows achaha parantasya angasya, what there will be ajantasya angasya, a vowel ending word will take what? Will take vriddhi. So ikara vriddhi is aikara, and thereby sthane antartamaha will give you sakhai. Sakhai. Sakhai plus au. Now hoayy is applicable. So therefore ai will take ay adesha by hoayy, and they will get sakhai plus au, sakhayau. So rupa siddhi is sakhayau. Then sakhayaha, similarly what? You will get sakha, sakhayau, sakhayaha. Then he sakhayau, then sakhayam, sakhayau, sakhin. Tritiya ekvachana is sakhya, then sakhye. Chaturthi ekvachana, sakhya, ityadi. So nothing else is needed there, no other sutras. With whatever we have studied, derivation follows. Now what happens here is that you have kya here in the anga. So next sutra is read for nyasi and nyasthana. Shashti ekvachana, panchami ekvachana and shashti ekvachana. Sometimes there are differences. Many times there are differences. In marut ityari shabda it is same. But then marut or matupanta shabda, they all have similar forms there. Panchami ekvachana, shashti ekvachana. And prathama, dvitiya, bahuvachana also have the same pratyaya. Asya is the content. But panchami shashti vary in rama shabda ityadi, hari shabda. So thereby from the prathama and dvitiya bahuvachana, so there nyasi and nyas have separate sutras. Here khyatyat parasya, the sutra is khyatyat parasya. After khya or tya, khya and tya are two different things. After them parasya, what? Khya or tya, akara is for uchcharana, khya and tya. After that what? Ataha ut. Ataha ut, akara will take utadesha. So the akara that follows khya or tya will take uadesha when this akara is the nyasi akara or nyas akara. Panchami ekvachana or shashti ekvachana pratyaya akara, that at akara will take ukara adesha following khya or tya. So sakhi shabda, here what happens is khi, sakhi, that is khi, not khya. But ikoyanchi has caused sakhya, khya. So now this khi has become, or sakhi has become khya. So after this khya, khyatyat parasya khya, after the khya and tya has been mentioned, so khya, khya ending word, sakhya, khya by ikoyanchi, ikara got the yakara adesha, ikoyanchi, and then sthane antartamaha. So this as is a nyasi as, or a gnyasas, then what will happen? This akara will take ukara adesha. So you will get sakhyas will become sakhyus, and then rutto visarga will be sakhyuhu. So sakhyu is panchami ekvachana as well as shashti ekvachana. औत, सो दिस औत वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन इन इदुद्भ्याम. सो द डिफरेंट कॉमेंट्रीज रीड द सूत्र डिफरेंटली. सो सम सूत्रास रीड द टू आदेशास टुगेदर एंड सम सेपरेट इट ऑल्सो विथ डिविजन. द सूत्रास आर सेपरेटेड ऑल्सो. सो औत वी सॉ अच्चघे अच्चघे एंड देन द अनुवृत्ति ऑफ इदुद्भ्याम औज्ञेहे. सो हियर औत सूत्र इज रेड सेपरेटली. औत इदुद्भ्याम ज्ञेहे इज द अनुवृत्ति देर एंड देन वॉट इज द मीनिंग ज्ञेहे. ज्ञेहे षष्ठी एक वचन ऑफ नी प्रत्यय विच इज सप्तमी एक वचन. सो सप्तमी एक वचन प्रत्यय वेन इट इज फॉलोइंग दिस इकारा और उकारा एंडिंग अंगा देन वॉट विल हैपन दे विल द प्रत्यय नी प्रत्यय इट्स विल टेक औत आदेश. वी सॉ अच्चघे दिस इज ऑल्सो रिप्लेस बाय अ एंड इन सॉरी हरी इकारा एंड उकारा दे आर बोथ रिप्लेस बाय अकारा वेन दे आर एंडिंग दे आर एट द एंड ऑफ द घी. सो दिस इज अ नॉन घी नाउ. ओनली इन घी द अच्च विल अप्लाय. सो दिस इज नॉन घी बिकॉज सखी असखी घ्यसखी शेषो घ्यसखी वॉज सेड. सो सखी शब्द वर्जित इकारा एंडिंग उकारा एंडिंग शब्दाज हैड गॉट द घी संज्ञा बट दिस सखी शब्द विल नॉट गेट घी संज्ञा. सो इट इज अ नॉन घी इकारा. दैट नॉन घी इकारा ऑफ शकी शब्द वेन इट इज फॉलोड बाय घनी प्रत्यय दैट नी प्रत्यय इज रिप्लेस बाय औ बट देर इज नो अकार आदेश फॉर द अंगा. सो वॉट विल हैपन हियर सखी प्लस नी विल बिकम सखी प्लस औ. इट इज रिप्लेस बाय औ सखी प्लस औ देन इको यणची विल गिव यू सख्य प्लस औ यू विल गेट सख्यौ. सो सख्यौ इज सप्तमी एकवचन. शेषम हरिवत ऑल अदर फॉर्म्स आर लाइक हरी नथिंग एल्स टू बी सीन देयर सखीभ्याम इत्यादि. देन पति शब्द इज ऑल्सो इकारांत बट इट इज नॉट लाइक हरी नॉर इज इट लाइक सखी. सो पति समास एव घी. सो इट डिपेंड्स ऑन वेदर इट इज लाइक हरी शब्द और लाइक सखी शब्द दैट क्वेश्चन इज देयर. सो जनरल रूल इज वॉट पति इज नॉन नॉट सखी देयर फॉर इट शुड गेट घी संज्ञा बट देर इज अ स्पेसिफिक सूत्र फॉर पति विच सेज इट विल बी घी इट विल बी कॉल्ड घी इट विल गेट घी संज्ञा ओनली इन समास. पति ही समासे एव समासे मीन समासे ओनली इन अ समास पति शब्द गेट्स घी संज्ञा बट इन अ नॉन समास मीनिंग वेन यू वॉन्ट टू डिक्लाइन ओनली पति नॉट अयोध्यापति सीतापति इत्यादि देन दैट पति विल नॉट बी अ घी संज्ञक देयर फॉर इट विल नॉट डिक्लाइन लाइक हरी शब्द. इंडिपेंडेंट पति शब्द विल नॉट डिक्लाइन लाइक हरी शब्द बट अधिपति सीतापति इत्यादि विल डिक्लाइन लाइक अयोध्यापति इत्यादि विल डिक्लाइन लाइक हरी शब्द बीइंग अ घी संज्ञक. सो नाउ हियर यू आर डिराइविंग द पति शब्द. सो इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू गेट पति शुड बी टर्म घी ओनली इन समास. सो इफ नॉट इन समास घी संज्ञा इज नॉट गिवन देन हाउ विल इट डिराइव. सो देर वेर इज सो वेर आर द डिफरेंसेस रियली. सो यू लुक एट इट इन इन द let's go to the table. So here there is nothing else. Pati in first case, second case, there is no difference. Meaning there is nothing to inquire there because this ghi sanya, where does it take? Where is the sanya pradesha? So it is in different pratyas. They are not the first case, second case. So what is done is that he directly jumps to what the sutra here. Pati samase eva. It takes the example of पंचमी एक वचन षष्ठी एक वचन पत्यु. सो हियर देर इज नो घी संज्ञा. सो पति प्लस न्यसी इन दी नित प्रत्यय फॉलोइंग काइंड ऑफ अ सिचुएशन व्हाट वी हैव सीन दिस ख्यात परस्य इत्यादि. सो हियर व्हाट लाइक पति प्लस न्यसी इट इज व्हाट पंचमी एक वचन प्रत्यय एंड इको यणची विल कॉज दिस पति फॉलोड बाय अस अकारा टू बिकम पत्य बाय स्थानांतरतम. सो विल गेट पत्य प्लस अस वॉट लेवन ख्यात परस्य ज्ञसिज्ञसुहो अतः उत अस विल बिकम उस उकार आदेश यू विल गेट पत्युहु. सो वॉट वॉज द डिफरेंस हियर इट इज जस्ट सेइंग दैट दिस पति समासे एव घी. सो ने नॉन सपति इंडिपेंडेंट शब्द इज नॉट अ घी, देयर फॉर वॉट एवर वॉज अप्लाइंग इन दी सखी शब्द दैट इज बींग एक्सटेंडेड नाउ बिकॉज इन वॉट वॉज अप्लाइड ख्यत्यात पर ख्य वॉज ऑलरेडी कंसिडर्ड नाउ त्य इज प्राप्त त्य वॉट अबाउट त्य हियर पति हैज बिकम पत्य सो दिस त्य नाउ इट इज नो लॉन्गर ती इट इज त्य जस्ट लाइक इन सखी देर वॉज नो खी देर वॉज ख्य सिमिलरली हियर पति इज नो लॉन्गर ती नाउ एंड ती एंडिंग इट इज त्य एंडिंग पत्य सो त्यत्यात पर आफ्टर दी त्य ऑफ पति ऑल्सो दिस सूत्र विल अप्लाई विच हैज बीन सीन इन दी केस ऑफ सखी शब्द देर बाय पत्यु देन इन नी स्थान ऑल्सो औत इदुभ्यांगे इको एणची विल गिव यू पत्य एंड देन यू विल गेट पत्यौ सो दिस सप्तमी एक वचन एवरीथिंग एल्स इज लाइक हरी सो ओनली वन सूत्र वॉज नीडेड विच इज वॉट पति शब्द विल बिकम घी ओनली इन समास समासे तू लाइक वॉट भूपति भूपति लाइक भूपत ये इत्यादि लाइक हर ये सिमिलर टू हर ये भूपत ये बट पति विल बी वॉट इन चतुर्थी एक वचन इट विल बी वेर इज इट सो हियर सो यू लुक एट इन पत्या पत्ये सो इन चतुर्थी एक वचन पत्ये बट इन लाइक सखे लाइक सखी शब्द बट इन दी केस ऑफ भूपति इट विल बिकम भूपतये सो हियर द डिफरेंसेस आर मार्क्ड हियर एवरीथिंग इज शेषम हरिवत नाउ कति शब्द कति कति शब्द इज ऑल्सो एंडिंग विथ इकारा कति शब्द सो कति शब्द इज इकारा एंडिंग इट गेट्स अ पर्टिकुलर संज्ञा वॉट इज दट संज्ञा संख्या बहुगणवतु दति संख्या सो बहुशब्द गणशब्द वतु वतु प्रत्ययंडिंग शब्द एंड दति प्रत्ययंडिंग शब्द दिस कति इज डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम दति प्रत्यय किम प्लस दति विल गिव कति हाउ मेनी एंड हाउ मेनी मीन्स इन प्लूरल सो देयर दैट कति विल डिक्लाइन ओनली इन प्लूरल इट इज इकारांता बट इट हैज गॉट संख्या एज अ संज्ञा इट इज अ संज्ञा सूत्र संख्या डज नॉट मीन नंबर हियर संख्या इज ओनली अ संज्ञा हियर कति विल बीइंग दति प्रत्ययंता इट विल बी कॉल्ड एज संख्या संख्या इज द संज्ञा फॉर इट सो हियर वॉट इज द संख्या इट इज डिफरेंशिएट डिफरेंशिएटेड एज वेदर अकृत्रिम और कृत्रिम सो अकृत्रिम मीन्स वॉट बाय नेचर संख्या इन रूढ़ी अर्थ वॉट डज इट मीन एक द्वि त्रि इत्यादि दे आर संख्या दे आर नंबर्स सो दी वर्ड्स विच डिनोट नंबर्स दे ऑल्सो कॉल्ड अ संख्या एक इज अ संख्या द्वि इज संख्या त्रि इज संख्या दिस इज वॉट वी ऑलरेडी नो बट कृत्रिम संज्ञा देर संज्ञा कृत्रिम इज वॉट इट हैज दी पारिभाषिक मीनिंग सो संख्या संज्ञा इज गिवन टू बहु गण वतु एंडिंग एंड दति एंडिंग देर फॉर कति कति इज नॉट रियली अ संख्या मीनिंग द वे वी नो एक द्वि त्रि बट इट इज गिवन अ नेम एज संख्या सो वाई इज दिस नीडेड बिकॉज टू डिराइव दैट वी नीड दति च षट संख्या सो दति च दति च दति प्रत्यय एंडिंग संख्या संज्ञक वर्ड इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड अ षट षट इज अनदर सो वॉट हैज ऑलरेडी गॉट संख्या दति च एंड दति प्रत्यय एंडिंग वर्ड्स विल नॉट ओनली गेट संख्या संज्ञा बट दे ऑलरेडी हैव संख्या संज्ञा नाउ इट इज ऑल्सो गोइंग टू गेट वॉट षट संज्ञा सो षट संज्ञा इज इंपॉर्टेंट टू डिराइव दिस देयर फॉर दि संज्ञा सूत्रस गिविंग संख्या एज द संज्ञा टू कति शब्द एज वेल एज षट एज संज्ञा टू कति शब्द दीज आर इंट्रोड्यूस देन वॉट विल हैपन हियर वाइल यू आर डिराइविंग इट विधि सूत्र षड भ्यो लुक सो दि षट शब्द मीनिंग षट संज्ञक शब्द विच इज दैट कति कति इज बींग डिराइव्ड हियर कति फॉलोइंग दिस कति विच इज अ षट संज्ञक शब्द आफ्टर दैट दिस जस सोह जस एंड शस प्रत्यास विल टेक वॉट लुक वॉट इज लुक नाउ वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ लुक सो हियर अनदर सूत्र इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड विच सेज प्रत्यस्य लुक् श्लूलुप अदर्शनं प्रत्यस्य अदर्शनं प्रत्यय विच इज हर्ड एंड disappears meaning is not heard anymore or when you are deriving it you are writing it also adarshanam which has darshana and then adarshana of that pratyaya is called as luk shlu or lup luk shlu lupa is bahuvachana luk cha shlu cha lup cha luk shlu lupaha सो प्रत्यय से अदर्शनम कैन बी कॉल्ड एज लुक ऑल्सो, इट कैन बी कॉल्ड एज श्लू ऑल्सो, एंड कैन बी कॉल्ड एज लुप ऑल्सो. सो एट सम प्लेसेस देर इज अ लुक आदेशा, श्लू आदेशा, लुप आदेशा. सो लुक आदेशा विल कॉज समथिंग, लुप आदेशा विल कॉज समथिंग, एंड श्लू आदेशा फॉर एग्जाम्पल श्लव सूत्र, इट विल इनवोक श्लू सूत्र, एंड देर विल बी अभ्यास द्वित्वम एंड अभ्यास कार्य फॉलोइंग, which we see in the third gana, gana dhatus. When we derive third gana dhatus, jyotyadi gana, so hu dhatu will become hu dvittva by shap coming and then going by adarshana is by shlu. So adarshana of the shap pratyaya in the third gana, which has been added as gana vikarna pratyaya for the hu ityadi dhatu, hu plus shap will give you what, will invoke the because it is a third gana dhatu, there will be shlau, where will be shlu. Shlu is the adesha by which there is adarshana of shap pratyaya, therefore shlau sutra will cause dvittvam, hu will become hu, and then abhyasakara ityadi jastvam ityadi, you will get juhu, and then you will get juhoti guna ityadi, and then tip pratyaya will be juhoti. So each of these luk, shlu and lup are terms for what? For adarshana, basically for lopa. But then why give three terms? Because the each of these terms has some use. There is sanya pradesha. So what will happen here? This luk, shlu ityadi will skip, will directly grow to there is general rule, utsarga as pratyay lope pratyay lakshanam. So pratyay lope pratyay lakshanam, even if pratyay lopa takes place, adarshana takes place, because lopa is also what? Adarshanan lopaha. So adarshana is called as lopa, and pratyaya se adarshanam is called as lopa also, it is called as luk also, it is called as shlu also, it is called as lup also. So four terms are there for pratyaya adarshana. And pratyaya lopa, when it takes place, pratyaya lope pratyaya lakshanam, there is a pratyaya lakshanam. So lup, shlu and luk are also lopa, they are also adarshan, they are also lopa. So pratyaya lakshana, the lakshana of the pratyaya should be maintained. Even if the pratyaya is not there, as though the pratyaya is there, that kind of a treatment should be given to the anga. However, pratyaya lupte sati tat pratyaya ashritam karyam syat, that karya would take place. Iti jasi cha iti gune prapte. Now what has happened? Kati plus jasi, suaujas. Because kati can decline only in bahuvachana, what are we doing? Kati, which is a dati anta pratyanta, dati pratyanta shabda, that kati shabda is ikaranta, it is a pullinga shabda, it is datiyanta shabda, it is what, sankhya sanyaka shabda, it is shad sanyaka shabda, therefore kati plus suojas, the first derivation will be prathama bahuvachana, because only bahuvachana pratyaya can be added to kati. Then जसी च इति गुणे प्राप्ते षड्भ्यो लुक, देन जसी च इति गुणे प्राप्ते, वाय? बिकॉज प्रत्यय लोपे, जस प्रत्यय इज गॉन बाय व्हाट, बाय षड्भ्यो लुक. सो देयर इज अ लुक हियर, दिस प्रत्यय विल गो अवे बाय लुक. सो जस प्रत्यय इज नॉट देयर, कति इज देयर. नाउ शुड कति टेक गुणा और नॉट? इट शुड टेक, सेज द पूर्व पक्ष देयर. वाय? जसी च इति गुणे प्राप्ते, वाय? प्रत्यय लोपे प्रत्यय लक्षण, दिस प्रत्यय लुक इज अदर्शन लोप, देर इज लोप ऑफ प्रत्यय जस, बट प्रत्यय लक्षण शुड बी देर. जसी च, ऑल्दो जस गोज अवे, दैट प्रत्यय लक्षण कार्य शुड बी देर फॉर कति, एंड गुण इज प्राप्त इति प्राप्ते. द नेक्स्ट सूत्र, निषेध सूत्र इज रेड देर, न लुमतांगस्य प्रत्यय लक्षण नास्ति इत्यर्थः. प्रत्यय लक्षण न कस्य, लुमतांगस्य, लुमत इज वॉट, लू, लू मत, लू एंड मतु प्रत्यय, लू मत. सो वॉट इज दैट? लुप एंड लुक आर लू, श्लू इज ऑल्सो लू, बोथ लुप, ऑल थ्री लुप, लुक श्लू लुप, लुक श्लू लुप एंड लुक ऑल्सो हैज लू, श्लू ऑल्सो हैज लू एंड लुप ऑल्सो हैज लू. सो दैट विच हैज लू, मीनिंग वॉट? That which has adarshana by lup, shlu or luk, shlu or lup, they, that is called as what? That pratyaya will be called as lumat. Na lumata angasya. So lumata angasya, when so lumata is in third case, na lumata angasya, when the pratyaya is elided by lu, which with the adesha having lu, meaning what it is, the which are the lumat now, so luk is lumat because lu asmin asti, asya asmin va asti iti lumat luk, luk is lumat, shlu is also lumat and lup is also lumat. So when the pratyaya is elided lumata, meaning we is having adarshana through luk, shlu or lupa adesha, then angasya pratyalakshanam na, anga cannot have karya which is pratyalakshana karya, therefore guna which was prapta is not there anymore because the jas pratyaya has gone by luk which is lumat. Because what has been said is that shadbhyo luk, so luk adesha was given, this luk is lumat adesha, through the lumat adesha, lumata, the adarshana has taken place, therefore pratyalakshana lope pratyalakshana karya will not take place, therefore guna won't take place, and thereby kati plus just will go away by shadbhyo luk, and then na lumatangasya, by that kati is the derivation, prathama bhuvachana. We'll stop here, we'll continue in the next part. Dhrutavasane nataraja rajo nanada dakkanna panchavaram uddhartu kamasanakadi siddhani tadvimarshe shiva sutra jalam. Namaste, dhanyavada.
Namaste.
Dhanyavada.